दोस्तों, प्रेजेंट स्पीच की सीरीज़ को मैं आगे बढ़ाऊंगा और आपको एक मैटर आज प्रोवाइड करूंगा। 1000 वर्ड्स की ये डिक्टेशन होगी और इस डिक्टेशन में इसकी स्पीड होगी 80 WPM। सो आपको मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं, बी रेडी फॉर इट। इट इज़ ए प्रिविलेज फॉर मी टू बी एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ ज़ाग्रेब, दिस हिस्टोरिक होम ऑफ थॉट and knowledge, which is celebrating its 350th anniversary this year. India's second president and my illustrious predecessor, Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, had visited this university in October 1965. I thank Dr. Boris and the University for this opportunity to once again bring to you the message of India. The University of Zagreb is renowned as a center for learning and scholarship. We in India have a special connect with this university and particularly its Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences for hosting the Department of Indology. The rich work that this department has undertaken in promoting the study of India has been invaluable. In studying India, our languages, our traditions, and our cultures, you have truly brought our two countries together. We are privileged to have partnered with you in many endeavors. Yesterday, we launched a Sanskrit chair and renewed the Hindi chair. These would yet again deepen our connect and collaboration. In India, we are proud inheritors of the legacy of ancient universities such as Nalanda, which flourished from the 5th to the 12th century AD. At its peak, more than 10,000 students studied a wide variety of subjects on its campus. Many of our modern universities were founded on the principles of strengthening technological prowess of India. This has paid rich dividends in the expansion of technological frontiers in India and by Indians across the world. Work on Indology is just one element of long history of linkages between India and Croatia, which date back to a time when our two countries were not the same political entities as we are today. We are aware of Croatians venturing to India as early as the 16th century as traders, as explorers, and as men of ideas. I understand that one of your leaders, Stephen Reddick, was highly influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. This year, we are celebrating the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation. For him, knowledge and education were about understanding the oneness of humanity and about harnessing the power of truth. On 2nd October, his bust would be unveiled in your historic capital. I do hope you will join the celebrations to remember his legacy and to imbibe his universal values. Our noted poet and the first non-Western Nobel laureate, Rabindranath Tagore, visited Zagreb in 1926. His lectures appear to have profoundly impacted well-known Croatian minds. We are delighted to see so many Croatian associations interested in Indian spiritualism, music, yoga, and Ayurveda. Intellectual curiosity and yearning in this country is second to none. Croatia's progress to a stable and prosperous democracy is indeed inspirational. Your journey as a member of the European Union, a key global partner for India, heralds a new beginning for you, and we wish you well. All of us would do well with a stronger Europe, one that should continue to anchor a multipolar world, uplifting multilateralism, strengthening global governance, and ensuring adherence to international laws and regulations. On our side, recent changes in India have been hugely transformational for our economic growth and upliftment of society. There is a new India in the making, as India that is aspirational, that is globally connected, that is impacting the global economy, that is willing to lead international efforts to find solutions to global challenges, be it climate change or building a new global architecture to deal with the menace of terrorism. Technology integration has been a key ingredient of our national development policy. We have many recent successes to talk about. The Indian Space Research Organization launched 104 satellites at one go, a feat unparalleled in the world. We are the only country to have successfully launched a mission to Mars in our maiden attempt, and at a cost that is less than what it takes to make a space science fiction movie by Hollywood. We are now aiming to launch a manned space mission in 2022 on the occasion of the 75th year of our independence. Thanks to our world-class institutions of higher learning, we now have the third largest scientific and technical manpower pool in the world, with 162 universities awarding over 4,000 doctorates annually. India's skill in information technology is well known. I am delighted that one of our major IT companies operates an office in Croatia, almost entirely with Croatian employees. India has a thriving research and development services market, which is expected to reach $38 billion US dollars by 2020. A third of the top 1,000 companies in terms of global research and development spending now have centers in India. Demography is another key element in the India of today. We are perhaps the world's youngest country with nearly half of our population below the age of 25 and nearly two-thirds of our population in the working age group. This is a generation that thrives on innovation and entrepreneurship. They are leading India's startup culture, particularly in the technology sector. We are now the largest consumer of mobile data in the world, ahead of the US and China put together. We also have the world's second largest internet base. And in all our efforts, we have not forgotten the essence of India, of pluralism and unparalleled diversity, of democracy, of rule of law, of upholding human rights, of standing up to terrorism and violence, of extending a hand in friendship to the world. Many challenges remain in our journey towards social and economic development, but we are confident that we are on the right path. As I have outlined, there is now a new India before you. Coincidentally, Croatia too is reaching out to the world. There is much we can do together. My visit, the first by a president of India to Croatia, is to reaffirm our hand of friendship and to invite Croatians, particularly its youth, to venture out to India. I invite you to explore and experience this new India of hope, of opportunity, of promise. दोस्तों, इसी के साथ ही डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. डिक्टेशन बहुत ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्ट नहीं है. कुछ इतने ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्ट वर्ड्स इसमें नहीं आए हैं. आप अगर आप इसकी अच्छे से प्रैक्टिस कर लेते हैं, इस तरीके के मैटर्स की अगर आपने पीछे से लगातार आप प्रैक्टिस करते आ रहे हैं, तो इन मैटर्स में आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी लिखने में, सिवाय दो चार वर्ड्स के. तो उम्मीद करता हूँ आप लोग अच्छे से लिख रहे होंगे. आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा अगली क्लास में अगले ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.